Hi guys, so a lot of people have been saying that about the intro being long. If you want to skip the intro, there's timestamps in the description. So you can just click on the description box and it will show you the timestamps and it will take you straight to the content. It's like 10 minutes in, just go to the description box and then expand the description box and then you'll be able to go straight to the content. If you want to ignore the intro. Okay, thanks for listening.
I don't know, but...
Now, you know what you need, Chantal? You need to get your butt out of the Middle East. You need to go back to Canada, and you need to start living a life that isn't just a big scam. I mean, this is silly. You're going to be 40 years old. You're out here, I mean, following some 29-year-old thinking that he's going to love you and marry you and make a life with you and whatever. Girl, come on. He laughs at you. He makes fun of you. I mean, why do you think you're over there with him? Because you guys are living it up? I mean, yeah, you really look like you're living it up. You really look like you're happy. What you need to do is you need to go back to Canada. You need to start putting in hard work. And you need to, if a relationship is really what you want, if that's your end game in life, I know it is for some people. If that's really what you want, someone to love you, someone to call you baby, someone to give you affirmations, whatever. I mean, slow steps. I mean, whatever. Get on the dating apps, work on yourself, get back to a point where you can walk for more than a minute without getting dizzy. I mean, that would, if I were that in that place, that would be my number one priority. Not who's going to call me baby when I put my head down at night. I mean, girl, come on. I mean, you're not going to be able to heal in this environment, let alone thrive. You're talking about energy. You're sitting here telling us how you're about to fall asleep.
So you're getting help. And you want to dunk on Chantel? And that's why I think Shannon and FFG's chemistry is so beautiful, because they're so similar. FFG has to be the hero. That's why she has to always dunk on Chantel with something. Like when she did the thing with BBJ, I stand on this. She did her big one. She did her big one with that one, especially with the way Chantel was running her mouth, talking about FFG's dogs. And when I saw her pull that off, I said, leave it to Chantel to have me applaud FFG. I was pissed. I was like, this was so good. She trolled the fuck out of you. Oh my God. So, just so we're clear, and you heard it here first. What happened with BBJ, rescuing BBJ? The BBJ rescue to FFG will be with the 89 LBs are to Amber. You will always hear about it for years to come. Always. That's never going to die. She did her big one. She had to make it public. And for those saying, oh, it was for the money, I think you guys forget, I've said this before, multiple things can be read at once. She did her big one and definitely helped BBJ, because at this point, I think almost anybody's better than Chantel. But yes, of course it was for the money. If it wasn't for the money, she wouldn't have made it public. Of course it was for the money. Are you kidding? The bitch held the whole... She shopped for BBJ's collar on stream. She shopped for a cat to get a Gucci collar for a cat. Of course it was for money. But I'm not going to take away the fact that, like, at least she got BBJ. But yes, it was for money. Yes, it was for content. Are you crazy? That is her 89 LBs, bitch. She is never letting that go. That will always be content in some way.
Isms. So... French fried girls should be worried because Chantal was threatening to sue again. Shadowed that she might have returned to Canada to handle some other business, and she would handle that while she was there. I would be terrified if I was French fried girl. So terrified. This is the woman who couldn't even make a vet appointment, and she's going to coordinate a multi-person lawsuit because she felt duped about her cat being given to somebody else. By her, to somebody else. But she couldn't tell you who, because the selfish bitch wouldn't even walk down the stairs to go say bye. She handed it to Pete's. Again, many reasons we can't follow through with our commitments. So. And Chantal doesn't have much tolerance for distress or discomfort. If something isn't exactly the way she wants to eat it, she's not going to eat it. If it's not the right temperature, she's not going to eat it. So you would think someone as large as her would be much more picky, or would be much less picky. But actually, some of the more morbidly obese people I know are rather picky about their food. And like other folks who deal with addiction, can get pretty nasty if they don't get what they want. How many people think that they've probably fought about food a couple times already? I'm sure he was fine with her coming over, but she farted out a bunch of promises initially that she was gonna go to the gym and lose weight and it'll be great and I'll be going to the beach and we'll be travel beezing. If you're too fat for a plane, you gotta do something. Because now you can't even get out of there in a hurry if you need to. There's no shame in buying 2 plane seats if you need them, but if you don't like that you need them or that you're cutting it close to needing them, whose job is it to change the shape of Chantal's body? Yours? Mine? A pill? Some Ozempic? No, it comes down to Chantal and what she chooses to do. At this point, she's had more resources and opportunities and access to treatment over the years that most people don't give a shit how she feels, or that she probably can't handle all of her ADLs maybe on her own. Because she was always such a nasty, self-centered person that her discomfort brings people pleasure. We've heard of Schadenfreude. You know, it's the same sort of thing. I don't want
So we saw some boats pass by while we were hanging out by the riverside and decided after we were done hanging out by the river to see if we could find a dock and take a boat ride ourselves. On our way,
it was his hard-earned money to try to buy her food that would support her health. And then either she ordered it without him or he came to reason of, look, I don't love you so much that $250 isn't worth risking your health to me. So if you really love me, Chantal, really, really love me, you'll go on there, eat yourself half to death, and give me the cash. So, I don't know. So, and she wants privacy. Okay. And where's your husband? Where's your husband? Where's your husband? Where's your husband? He's out with the boys. Thailand, from what I understand, has a very, very active sex scene. So, I'm sure he'll text you. But at any rate, this week we're going to... But she's sitting there, not a lot of people around, but it was the old eyes darting. Remember the outhouse? Or going for Burger King and then sitting in the parking lot, full face of makeup, looking all over the place to see who's looking and who's watching. She's out proud and doesn't care, but hawks like she's ashamed of what she's engaging in. So when she's sitting there with Sala eating, and there's people, you know, not a lot of people, because they go everywhere when it's closed. She's afraid of people, and they want to be able to film, and they're weird. They're weird. She likes getting attention, but standing out doesn't really, like, I think she probably feels like people are staring, because they are staring. It's a spectacle. She's 4 times the size of a normal woman. So I think people are going to stare. That shouldn't be unexpected. Is it rude? Is it cruel? I don't know. Bottom line, it shouldn't be unexpected. And to act shocked would be kind of stupid as well. You've read about it a little bit and saw it on TikTok. Please look better after yourself. Take better care of yourself. If not you, for your husband that you told us you love so much. How much do you love him if you're willing to eat yourself to death because it's too difficult to try to get better? Beyond 36 hours. If you're... I'm not a 12-stepper, but the bondage of self. She's so obsessed with meeting her own wants and needs that she, to her inadvertently, steps on people and hurts people in that way. There's another side of Chantal that is a complete sociopath and pretty much doesn't care about feelings, doesn't know how to act. That's why we had the wedding cake and candles and she erupted like she was going to shit her pants. Because she doesn't know what happiness feels like, so she doesn't demonstrate what it looks like. She doesn't know love. She doesn't know any of those feelings. And so with all this spinning in her head, her marriage on the line, her citizenship being up, she goes on a diet.
One, I'm pretty, okay? That has a lot, and I don't mean that to be conceited. I'm being very matter of fact. Being pretty gets you a lot of privilege. I'm just saying, you can get away with a lot if you're pretty. Number one, I'm pretty.
Okay, guys, so this is the trailer for Femme. It's been released in Europe, but it's out. It's a thriller, and I've seen it. It's a fantastic film. It is out in Spain, and it is out in the US on March the 22nd. So here is the trailer.
Well, you can't turn around if you're a fucking man.
You're letting them win.
How do you want to deal with that?
I think you're a nice looking lad.
On your foot.
I'm a nice guy. If you disrespect me, fuck you up.
I get that.
Yeah?
Yeah, I'm the same.
Oh, you're not.
You're a fucking big man!
Best remember not to fuck with you then.
Hi guys, and welcome to Tailored Talk. So before we go on to Foodie, I just wanted to talk about Zachary Michael for a minute. If you didn't already know, a few days ago he made a video stating that he split up with his long-term partner Noel, who he's been with for 7 years.
Today, I just want to share some difficult news in my life and my personal life. I think I have made it quite clear that the past few weeks now, I think it's like been 3 or 4, I have been struggling. I've been emotionally struggling, and unfortunately that's because my relationship with Noel has ended. I care about Noel a lot, so I'm trying to be mindful of like what to say and what is important and what's not important in terms of things that the internet needs to know, because the last thing I want is like anybody on the internet to go bother Noel or things like that. But it has been very difficult for me. I now understand maybe a little bit about like the urge that some of the girls have to come onto the internet and immediately just like say everything that's on their mind ever about things like this, because in so many ways, I guess maybe less here on YouTube and more so on Twitch. Like on Twitch, I usually literally daily give updates about things that are happening in my life, things that I've been doing, things that I've been up to, and it's very hard because also in my life, a lot of those things up until now have always included Noel. Like, I spend so much of my time and my day with Noel, and so, yeah, very difficult to not come on to the internet and immediately share those things, and to that extent, like, I guess I understand why Amberlynn Reed might, like, immediately come onto the internet and start talking about a breakup. I'll also say that's not what I did, though. So, like, I still didn't do that. It was really hard not to, because, you know, like, this has really changed my life. Like, the past month of my life doesn't feel real.
From his video, from what I gathered, it sounded like Noel's decision, and Zach never saw this coming. His video kind of reminds me of a YouTuber and influencer called Sarah Ashcroft. I've mentioned her on this channel before. She's a social media girl. She's an entrepreneur with over 1 million followers on Instagram. She has her own, she is the creator and CEO and has her own luxury fashion brand called SLA. I'll put her channel link in the description if you want to see who she is. And earlier this year, she was dumped by her partner Joe, who she was with for 6 years. I'm going to show you a clip from her breakup video.
This is definitely not a video that I ever thought I would be filming. Some of you may have seen already from social media that Joe and I have broken up. I've been umming and ahhing about filming a video for YouTube, but one thing that has become so clear since announcing my breakup with Joe was how many people are going through almost an identical situation to me. And if I can speak candidly about my relationship and everything that happened, if it helps even just one other person feel less lonely during their breakup, then at least something positive will have come from this completely shit situation. I really wish that this was one of those videos where I could sit here and say that this was a joint decision and that we both decided that we were better off as friends. But unfortunately, it's not like that at all. And this was very much a one-sided decision on Joe's side. This wasn't my choice at all. And it was a shock to some extent because I just never thought that. I just thought I was going to marry him. I thought he was my person. I loved him more than anything and would have done anything for him. I never thought that it would end, basically.
Now, I'll show you Zach's.
And I also was like taking my time to say, because I really just hope things could change. I really wanted to make things work. I mean, like, I feel like it should say something that, like, Noel didn't do anything to me, that I'm... I was gonna say that I'm not upset about. I mean, I'm upset and frustrated with the situation, but, like, as a human, I care about Noel. I want the best for Noel, and it seems like the best for Noel is something else, at least right now, and... coming to terms with that every day is very difficult, and it's very tough, and I think the part that's frustrating is that I don't feel like I've done anything wrong, and I still love Noel, and I just really, pictured my life with him for the rest of my life. I pictured me together with Noel for the rest of my life, and so I feel like everything I thought I knew is just simply not what I thought it was. So, yeah, no, I feel like I just, like, I don't know. I used to tell people all the time, people would be like, any advice for turning 30? They'd get cameos from me, and they'd be like, advice on turning 30? And I'd be like, my 30s are great. Like, I've got it all figured out. I have everything figured out. I've achieved all my dreams. I have a YouTube channel. I have a dog. I have a loving partner, a home with said loving partner. Like, I have got it all figured out. And it's just like, you can be wrong. You can be wrong. You can, in fact, be wrong.
As you can tell, they are the same kind of video. Which makes me think that, like Sarah, Zach was completely stunned and surprised by the breakup. And the one thing that Zach said that stuck with me was, I don't feel like I've done anything wrong. And to that, I'll just add, Zach, sometimes it has nothing to do with being wrong or being right. Zach, you could have been the most perfect, loving, exciting, considerate boyfriend in the world, and Noel still would have found a reason to break up with you. I just want to say that it seems like from the video that you put out that these are Noel's issues and decisions, and that Noel is going to have to live with those decisions for the rest of his life. And I hope that Zach doesn't beat himself up over Noel's decisions and Noel's choices. And I know that Zach feels like shit now, as we all do when we go through breakups. But one day, Zach, you will wake up one day in the morning and realize that this was Noel's loss, not yours. Now, with Sarah's situation, after the breakup, Sarah is now on TikTok, she's on Instagram, but I do notice, because I'm on YouTube, that she hasn't put up a YouTube video in about 6 months. And when she does, this will be her first video after the breakup with Joe. And I hope that Zach doesn't stay away for like 6 months. I really hope that Zach still puts up YouTube reactions because he's so talented and I'm a big fan of his. But I can understand if he doesn't come back for a very long time. Because breakups are a bitch and can really take you out of the game for a while. So I'm wishing Zach and little Poe, his dog, all the best for the future, and I can't wait to see them both back on YouTube again. So guys, I'm going to move on to the foodie news. Now guys, I know that Foodie is now back in Kuwait, but I've got some hotel business that I want to cover with you. The creator Truth Hurts, who was a woman that was in the same hotel as Foodie, and also noted that this girl said that Foodie fucked up the hotel air conditioning system because she kept on the air conditioner all day and night and the hotel staff were complaining.
Okay, really fun story. When I saw the little clipping of the staff talking in Shantan's video's background, I took that little clipping and I sent it through WhatsApp to the reception because we have a WhatsApp communication with the reception. And the girl wrote back a harmless little reply that they're talking about the AC leakage that has happened in that room. And now the issue is spreading throughout the hotel and there's a lot of extra work because of that. And they were bitching and moaning about that. So I was like, fine. And I reported that on Twitter just now. Come here. Come closer. Okay. Just now, the housekeeping team was here and I caught one of the girls in the housekeeping team. And I was like, can you listen to this and tell me exactly what they're saying? So she listened to it like a couple of times. And then she's like, yeah, they're talking about, water leakage from AC. And also, like this. She's showing me and I was like, dang.
But on top of that, Foodie, as you well know, was also a super slob in the hotel as well. Now, we know that Foodie has always been gross. She has always been a slob. She has never cleaned up after herself. We know that with BB, she didn't throw out old takeaway boxes and BB had to work and come home and clean. We know that Foodie and Pete's were pigs when they lived at the villa. She's laughed about fruit flies, moldy boxes and moldy pots. We now know that she's a slob in Kuwait that just eats on the floor when Salah chucks her burgers and fries. But it seems that she was also giving the hotel staff extra grief as well. So now let's talk about Foodie getting that letter of complaint from the hotel in Thailand. So I'll just roll the clip.
Dear guest, thank you for staying with us. Daily room cleaning that requires cleaning every day. If you do not want to clean your room every day, the next cleaning must be within 2 days. According to the cleanliness measures set by the Ministry of Public Health regarding cleanliness for hotel businesses that provide daily room service. If there is a lot of garbage, please take it to the garbage room at the end of the corridor. What? I forgot about the garbage room at the end of the corridor. Yeah, so a garbage room. We will clean your room tomorrow, today. Please keep the makeup room sign on the door. If you don't let us clean the room tomorrow, damage may be charged on the day of checkout. I do it so they don't have to clean every day. Okay, so if there's a lot, they want to keep the stink to them. No, I mean, it's not, after 1 day, your room is not dirt, shouldn't be dirty. You know? I didn't realize it was that long. I thought it was only 2 days.
I hope they do charge her. She also admits that she's been shitting and crapping in her underwear and putting the underwear in the bin. And I just wanted to ask, like, which bin? Is it the bin, like, that's outside of her hotel room, or like the bin in the hotel room? Because if it's in her hotel room bin, she may have stunk the place out, and there may have been complaints from her neighbors. Foodie moans about the garbage room down the corridor. She's way too lazy and spoiled to walk down the corridor. So how long has she just been hoarding, you know, half-eaten fast food in there? How long has she been hoarding moldy boxes in her room for? She says that her room doesn't get dirty after one day. But guys, we all know how Foodie is. Now, when cleaners knock on the door and say, cleaners, can we come in? You can always refuse the cleaners and tell them to come back for another time. So my question is, how long did she refuse the room cleaners when they came knocking in the morning? And if she knew the garbage, and if she knew about the garbage room down the hall, why didn't she use it? This is also the second time, as she says, this is the second time she's had the same letter from the same hotel staff that she got last year. And it's like, well, a few months ago, rather. And it's just like, how long did she tell the room cleaners to stay away? Because now they want to come and clean her room every couple of days. I just find it crazy that the cleaning staff went in there one morning, and now it's so bad that she's got a written letter of complaint and has to let the cleaning staff in every 2 days, or else there will be trouble. And it made me wonder, guys, remember when Foodie and Salah were in Thailand the last time, and 2 weeks of a visa run turned into a month, and they was clearly bad blood because they were arguing all the time. Foodie was going out alone at night. She was going out in the morning alone for coffee, and she just wanted to be by herself. She was clearly in a bad mood. They were arguing all the time. Salah was very obviously losing the will to live, and I thought that he was pissed off at her because it was taking so long for her visa to be accepted. But what if Salah was annoyed because Foodie was so filthy McNasty that she couldn't keep her room clean? Guys, maybe that's why they were arguing, because she was so dirty and Salah had to share a room with all of her stench and all of her filth. Imagine being so dirty that you're getting repeated letters to let cleaners in because your room is so filthy. Imagine being so big that you're breaking sofas. Imagine being so disgusting that you could get fined for it. If Foodie's not careful, guys, she could get banned from that hotel. And I wouldn't blame the staff one freaking bit. They deserve medals for the literal shit that Chantal has put them through over the last however many weeks. Okay, guys, that's the end of the video. I know she's back in Kuwait now, so this video is kind of old news. But I just had to talk about the letter, because who gets a letter of complaint from the hotel staff? Only Chantal. Okay, guys, that's the end of the video. If you're still here, thank you for watching. Thank you for listening. I'll see you in the next one.